the man he admired the most, Jesus Christ. Your Excellency, my father always alikuwa na mambo matatu kama wewe, not the same, but all his speeches were divided into three. Today I'll divide it into four because he was a foster general. Firstly, you've heard from Bishop Lele about his love for God. Somewhere in that helicopter wreck is his Bible, which was his most precious possession. Anyone who worked with him in DHQ, MAB, LAB, wherever, can attest that he always had a Bible with him. And I am hoping they're able to retrieve it from the accident. I'd want to keep it as a memento, and for the rest of the family as well. His Bible meant a lot to him, and between me and him, the rest of the family, my mom and my wife, were a bit slow, but we'd always engage in a competition for reading the Bible and discuss the mortality and all these things of life. He understood that his position was temporary and it would always end. Leading up to his death, he almost knew that his time was up. Despite having very many plans for the military and for his family, but he spoke in a certain tone that would suggest that, my son, I won't always be here, and you will need to take care of my wife and my other children, which I am more than ready to do, and it will not be a problem. And Matthew 5:3, Beatitudes of Jesus, it says that blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. He was the poorest man in spirit. Easy chase cars mingi, ofisi kubwa, watu kumuita CDF, general, sir. To him it was all vanity. It was a necessary thing for him to be able to fulfill his job. Nothing more. As he lays here with his uniform, I see they put his medals, his sword and boots. He loved it as a tool for the job, but nothing more. Don't be under any illusion that he thinks is important once he breathed his last. That was point number one, his love for God. His point number two and point number three is a very blurry line. It is about his soldiers and his family. I can guarantee you right now, ule private mwenye amekaa pale juu kwa kona and me, he viewed us almost the same. You may not have had the same privileges I might have had being his son, but in his heart of hearts, the lowest person, the cleaner, to his vice, he treated all of them with respect. And he respected every single human life. His worst days was when he had, different days he hears his soldiers have been hit. He was actually mourning like he was mourning a child. And he'd go down to his knees and ask, God, what is happening here? Hard for me strength. Naitaji kulima hii Al-Shabab kabisa. Naitaji kulima hii bandits kabisa. Which is what he was doing in the line of duty when he went down. And I want to tell even the bandits or Al-Shabab who are celebrating, mtu mwenye alikuwa na lima lima kila wakati, muongeze click. Watu ya SF, mukipewa mission ya kwenda kulima adui, maliza kabisa. Na ukifanya skirmishing, confirm. Waongeze tatu za kichwa. That's how he would have wanted it. He wanted to die, in fact, fighting one of these enemies. And so, musikubali kuogopa Al-Shabab. Kama mdosi wenyu haku anogopa adui, basi mnaogopa nini? Si yeye amelala hapa, na sisi wote tutalala hapa. Usipende maisha yako yote sana, na iko kitu moja kubwa kushinda wewe, Mwenyezi Mungu na nchi yetu ya Kenya. Lima Al-Shabab, lima musiangushe click, muongeze. Watu ya Boni endeleeni kuongeza click kabisa, because his ultimate dream was to have a fully peaceful Kenya. Hii mambo ya watu kugongo gongwa hitting civilians left, right and center, he had told me many times, General Karangi started that or that side, I will finish it. He may not be the one to finish it, but all of you now have a responsibility. Musiangushe yo click, wekeni juu. And he always used to say, kazana, weka, kazi mbele, na mungu mbele. Now, lime adui kabisa, lime adui. Atakufanyia nini, utakuja hapa, we'll celebrate you, but Kenyans will remain safe. Those tears of the women in Baringo, and their children, and the people, they won't go in vain. Hata sasa wenye wako deployed huko, wenye walichukua mili zao kwa ndege, don't despair, but kazi inaendelea. He's gone, amri bado iko. Since ametoa amri, hiyo mali lazima ifagiliwe kabisa. Na hivyo ndio itakuwa. That was point number 2 and 3. I'll talk about his family briefly. He really loved his wife. And he loved us also as a family. And he did everything for us. Anything he was ready to sacrifice for us. He believed in us completely, and his wife, I know, he kept on telling me, unajua nikienda sasa wendo utachunga mama, and mom, I will take that job seriously, na nitakuchunga to the best of my ability. Lastly, if you knew General, he loved reading, he loved playing golf. I know his golf buddies really miss him. And he said in an interview, when Excellency appointed him, was the last time he played. And just when we were talking on Saturday, I told him, sasa ukiretire, itakuwa aje? And he told me, I look forward to going back to golf. But his primary consideration always was this great nation of Kenya. He loved it. And in his death, he wishes that Kenya will remain totally secure, free from external influence, and any Kenyan, be it from Baringo, Chemolingot, Lamu, Mandera, Wajia, any corner of this country, he wanted them to be safe. A child to go to school, get an education, pursue their dreams, and he died doing that. And there is no greater death for him. He loved, besides his golf reading, I believe we as a family genuinely believe General had more than 24 hours in a day. Because in a day, Tuesdays and Fridays, in fact, we are normally here. This Tuesday we were here doing the Defense Forces physical readiness test. He said, if I'm the General, I have to show that this test is possible. And ironically, he did, I think, the most press-ups of everyone here. Yeah, not the most press-ups, but the most push-ups. We did push-ups. He did 80 of them at his age, over 60. He did press-ups, I think about 50, and he ran 3.2 kilometers in about 19 minutes, which is absolutely phenomenal for his age. So, pia nyinyi, muku kwa juu, watu ya vitambi, fuateni mwenende ya General. Sunona metoshea kwa sanduku vizuri. Awaja finya finya toshe vizuri. And so, lastly as I finish, the most important lesson. Should you disregard his love for God and what God can do to you in your life and the battles he can help you win? Should you disregard everything? I can tell you something. Ukiwa na mkono gam, hautaipata baraka. Even when God wants to give you money and resources, you need to open your hands. You need to empty your pockets. Patiana. General, if yosia umulize, yosa umevapo, nipatie, anakupatia. General, limekuwa maapa, nisaidie. He will give you. He was so generous, and as a result of that, as a family, we have never lacked. I am to just try. Test your faith. Test your faith. Start. Mwenye nakombanga pesa, hata umechoka na yaji. Give him, forget about it. Najua apa, he told me the amount of debt ordered to him, and I enjoyed him. If you ever die, eh? Kwa mazishi yako, nitaenda nianze kuchukua hizo madeni yangu, ndio at least nijenge mambanya, nyumba mahali. But akasema apana, iyo ni sadaka nimepatia Mungu. And so, generosity. Just test your faith. Iyo wacheni kushikilia vitu kwa mfuko. Fungua mkono, God will bless you. We will miss him. He was a great, great, simple man. And we love him. And to the entire KDF fraternity, Poleni Sana, we stand with you. And especially for the people who perished with him. We, in fact, were running with that whole group here on Tuesday. And Tuesdays and Friday were his days. If I can ask, kwa makambi zenyu, chukweni yo fitness serious, mkwe muna kimbia kimbia, so that at least you can take the physique and also better your own health. Asante sana, and God bless all of you.